This week, we're in Costa Rica fishing for blue marlin.
If I'm not hunting, you can bet I'm fishing for blue marlin.
Take this serious, huh?
Maybe a little.
There he is!
The heck with that rocking boat stuff. Me and my family, we're gonna have some adventures of our own.
I'm gonna die.
Our lives move pretty fast, but it's only in the moment of the hunt that life slows down. It's not a matter of what we do, but how we do it. With passion, drive, and the challenge to accept nothing but our best, we are the Wildlifers.
This week, we're in Costa Rica fishing for blue marlin.
Dan loves to blue marlin fish. And every year, we go to Costa Rica, and I'm looking forward to a couple days of fishing, some good food. Can't wait to bring in a big fish.
You know, this fishing thing, this boat is big and it's nice, but let me tell you something, that sucker rocks.
First of all, Dustin can't ride in the back seat of a car. He gets car sick. You know, if he rides in an airplane facing toward the back, he gets air sick. If he gets in a boat, he gets seasick.
It's miserable. There's nothing worse than being seasick.
So the likelihood of you seeing Dustin on the boat out in the ocean when it's not tied to the dock is very slim. Well, our plan is to watch the weather, catch a window, go blue marlin fish for 2 days, come back in, I go back to being the enemy of fun, and Stephanie and Dustin can go play on the beach in the zip lines.
Dan and I both love to go fishing, and he has found a great place to find fish, and it's Costa Rica. We love it.
I like to fish in Costa Rica because of the numbers of blue marlin that you see there on a daily basis versus other places in the world.
When you can get 34, 35 blue marlin in a day, that's insane. That's insane fishing. That's dream blue marlin fishing anywhere else.
So just like everything that Dan does it to the extreme, and he wants to be the best at it.
You know, Dan's passion for hunting, it's the same for fishing.
Anything that I do, I try to do it a little bit better than I'm probably capable of doing, and blue marlin fishing is no different. I'm absolutely a perfectionist at blue marlin fishing, just like I am about hunting. Nothing that I ever do is good enough. You know, I always want to continue to get better and get better and get better, and I can't tolerate a moment of fun and relaxation and things like that that people do when they fish. That's just not for me. It's a war for me. It's me against the blue marlin, and it's how many of them that I can hook and bring to the leader. I hire the best there is in the business and try to be the very best we can be at.
Andy kind of mirrors that with Dan. They both like it. They both want to be the best at it.
I really like to catch fish. I don't want to just catch one, I want to catch them all.
My captain, Andy, is a guy that I've been after for a long, long time. I've known Andy since we were basically teenagers. I consider him to be the best at fishing. He is by far the most loyal. He treats my money as if it were his own. I can't say enough good things about Andy Flood. He is the best there is, and I feel sorry for everybody else who didn't get him.
Before we head out and fish, we have to go to the grocery store and stock the boat. So Swoop and I, we head out and we get all the supplies we need, and we enjoy going to the grocery store because we've met friends in Capos and we enjoy being there.
The
wildlifers are heading out from Capos, Costa Rica, and plan on driving through the night. Sights are set for a location offshore on Costa Rica's seamounts, where world-class and record-number blue marlin can be found. It's the wildlifers' first morning of marlin fishing, and gear is getting rigged up. But in the middle of the night, Andy got a lead on different coordinates, where the bite had been hitting double digits.
We kind of changed our mind in the middle of the night and decided to go to a different place out here to fish. They've been getting a ton of bites here. Andy talked to some guys from Los Sueños yesterday. One guy got 16 bites in a day, another guy got 18 bites in a day. So I think sometime during the night, Andy changed our course to this place. There's already three boats here. Right now, we are fishing four lures, two teasers, two dredges. Just kind of trolling around, kind of paying attention to our teasers. Just waiting to see if we can't start raising some fish. So we'll give it till at least the tide change to see what happens.
Well, this morning we're out there and, you know, hopes are high.
Usually I wake up and, you know, I'm already caught a fish by now.
The trip before, we had caught 18 marlin in one day.
Reel, reel, reel!
After 3 or 4 hours of trolling around and seeing absolutely nothing, you know, I'd look up at Andy and he'd do that. That means no bait on the recorder. It was just a biological desert. There was nothing there. So we start, you know, talking among ourselves, you know, what do we need to do? I mean, you just don't see days that are that slow in Costa Rica. But we were living it and it couldn't happen at a worse time because we had everybody here to film it.
Right about now, it's looking like Dustin and his family had the right idea staying on land to enjoy a fun day zip lining in the Costa Rican jungle.
Of course, the one thing my family wants to do, go zip lining.
Have fun!
Woo! You know, Miles, he takes after his mama. Now, Lacey, she has no fear of heights. Miles, he has no fear of nothing. You know, he's too young, I guess, to be scared, but most little kids are scared of stuff like that. I know he's strapped in and everything, but as a dad, when you see your kid, you know, looking off a 100-foot platform, and he's fine with it, you know, he's just like his mama. They're both crazy.
Two, three, do it!
Not a chance. I'm not doing none of that.
I've been on several trips with Lacey, and we always have the most fun. That girl is crazy.
You just let it slide all the way down, okay?
Okay.
Ready?
Oh my goodness. I'm not gonna have a wife when we get home. She's gonna splat at the bottom.
She always likes to do the most wildest, most adventurous stuff, like full throttle.
Go! I'm gonna die!
Oh my God!
As Dustin does his best not to commit suicide, back on the boat, the Bremen's luck on the water may finally be turning around.
What shotgun? There he is! He's there!
We finally get a bite. Okay. They finally showed back up. Now it's gonna turn on.
He's there!
I know it's a bummer, but my job, other than to eat and sleep, is to bring all the fish in. Yes. If somebody's got to do it, I guess it'll be me. He's there. Doesn't know he's been caught, literally. He's right here.
Hook pulled.
That's the part about fishing. It's like a big production and everybody's doing their job and everything goes smoothly until we lost the fish.
But to troll around for this long and not see but this one fish, it's just unheard of. I mean, you don't move your entire operation from the Caribbean through the Panama Canal to the Pacific, buy a dock, rent a house to see one fish in 6 hours. You don't do that.
It's just like hunting, you know, you see a big, nice buck and you get out in position and he runs away. It's just, that's hunting, that's fishing, that's why we like to do it.
Yeah, well, you know, we're trolling around there and nothing's happening. And, you know, we're staring a hole in the ocean, just looking, come on, come on. And I hear Swoop go, there he is, left long.
There he is, left long, he's there.
So I see the fish out there, he's jumping, you know, I'm trying to get the line in as fast as I can, keep all the slack out of the line.
Come on up, there he is. Hang on, let him chill out.
The wildlifers are fishing for blue marlin off the coast of Costa Rica. And after losing their first fish, they finally got a second chance.
There he is, left long! He's there!
So I see the fish out there, he's jumping, you know, I'm trying to get the line in as fast as I can, keep all the slack out of the line.
Come on up, there he is.
So finally we get into the boat, we can see him coming up, we see all the colors changing in the water, Swoop's getting into position so he can release the fish, and I get to let go of the rod and go over and look at him, and God, they're just beautiful fish. It was a great catch.
Oh, yeah.
Supposed to catch a lot of fish just like that. That's how it's supposed to happen. Another one for the Piranda. Here he goes. I'm hot and tired. That was hard work. And my water's frozen. It was good. That was fun. My arms wore out. It was a lot of work. I'm ready for the next one now.
I grew up blue marlin fishing. From the time that I was 1 year old, I was in the Bahamas with my family every year for the summer, bill fishing. And during that time span, we've always had the same boat names in that my father owned a boat called the Lisa, and my grandmother owned a fishing boat called the Cosa and the Sapo, and her mother ship, which was a yacht, was called the Piranda. Now, Piranda is a Spanish word that means spree. Literally translated, it means a drinking spree, but I kind of changed it to mean a fishing spree since I don't drink anymore. When I had the opportunity to have my own boat, I wanted to name it something that had always been in the family. And I was very close with my grandmother, and I felt like that I wanted to use that name, so I went and talked to my brothers and mother about it, and it was fine with them. They had no plans to use it. So I named my boat the Piranda, and that's how the name of the boat came to be.
So when there's downtimes on the boat, you know, there's a lot of quiet time, and Dan doesn't like to listen to music on the boat, you know, the whole enemy of fun thing, so, but he always has his way of entertaining everybody.
Oh. Oh my God.
Well, yeah, when the fishing's bad, you got to do something to save your sanity. It's just a little sideline entertainment until the Blue Marlin show up. So I'm always looking for a way to force Andy to see me eat cottage cheese or do something gross with curdled milk, because he acts like a total three-year-old.
You are, please don't ever put that on video. That is disgusting.
Eat it! Eat it!
I don't like cottage cheese or blue cheese or rotten milk or anything along that lines, and all that, that's what that stuff is to me.
No.
Eat it! Eat it!
I did it! And he got it on video.
Guys do the most disgusting things. I'm not talking about it.
Well, we've had a slow little run at it. You know, everybody's kind of down. We were hoping for a lot better fishing. You know, weather's not cooperating that great, and the fishing is very, very slow. We finally get another bite. He's a strong one, you know. She's really trying us on, but we are bound and determined to catch this one and get it up next to the boat.
Determination to get this fish. After you've missed a couple, the pressure's on. You gotta get this fish. Working so hard, doing their job, because everyone's really gonna get this fish in. We gotta add our numbers to the boat. Another job well done.
That was awesome. That's how it's supposed to go. Not like, you know, for an hour.
Perfect.
Now that's why we do this.
Day 3 arrived, fishing for blue marlin offshore of Costa Rica. However, after a few days of silent seas, the wildlifers began to worry for the first time ever their Costa Rica trip may be a bust.
We wake up the next morning. Again, you know, you got high hopes, you're in Costa Rica, and the fishing's dead. And after an hour or so, I finally told Andy, you know, man, I've had about all this, I can take. Turn this thing toward Capos and let's go home.
So, I guess we'll call it a day, we'll cut our losses, and we'll head to the house. Costa Rica is so much fun. Fishing might not have been as great this week, but next week, it'll be better. Fishing here in Costa Rica, it couldn't be better. I love this place.
You know, the Piranha, they had a tough week of fishing, but that's not the norm there. You know, Costa Rica is one of the hot spots in the whole world for sports fishing. They catch so many blue marlin. Dan and Stephanie, they catch more marlin there than they do most other places in a whole season, and they'll catch that many in 1 3-day trip. Hey, my family and I,
give me some.
We had a blast. We came down, we went swimming, and we went zip lining. What a better place to go than Costa Rica to do all those things.
Blue marlin fishing is what I do in the summer. And just like I do everything else, I do it in the best place with the best people. Costa Rica is a prime example of that. It is remarkable. This particular trip turned out to not be so remarkable. We all know why that is. A cameraman brought a yellow bag on the boat.
Hey, I haven't spent a lot of time on Dan's boat, but even I know, don't bring anything yellow, not even yellow underwear.
With a little bit of luck next time, they'll get a little bit more color coordinated and we'll do a little better. But until then, I'm gonna be catching the hell out of Blue Marlin because I'm not gonna let them bring their yellow bag on the boat anymore.
All your wildlife or social media needs, make sure to follow them on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram.